The Edinburgh Lectures on Mental Science. Chapter 1. Spirit and Matter. In commencing a course of lectures on mental science, it is somewhat difficult for the lecturer to fix upon the best method of opening the subject. It can be approached from many sides, each with some particular advantage of its own. But, after careful deliberation, it appears to me that, for the purpose of the present course, no better starting point could be selected than the relation between spirit and matter. I select this starting point because the distinction, or what we believe to be such, between them, is one with which we are so familiar that I can safely assume its recognition by everybody, and I may therefore at once state this distinction by using the adjectives which we habitually apply as expressing the natural opposition between the two living spirit and dead matter. These terms express our current impression of the opposition between spirit and matter with sufficient accuracy, and considered only from the point of view of outward appearances, this impression is no doubt correct. The general consensus of mankind is right in trusting the evidence of our senses, and any system which tells us that we are not to do so will never obtain a permanent footing in a sane and healthy community. There is nothing wrong in the evidence conveyed to a healthy mind by the senses of a healthy body, but the point where error creeps in is when we come to judge of the meaning of this testimony. We are accustomed to judge only by external appearances, and by certain limited significances which we attach to words.